phenomenal you are.
Phenomenal.
You never cease to amaze me, but maybe maybe these days be the first for which I see clearly.
Hear me, feel me.
Eternally indebted to your existence, for you are the first teacher, bringer of new life, queen, mother, grandmother, sister, wife, mixed with all types of unique spice to create the ninth wonder of the world. And Let this be my declaration of your inner and outer beauty, strength, courage, and truly blessed with an abundance of life. And they say behind every strong man there's an even stronger woman, and behind that strong phenomenal woman is a pathway that leads to forever and tomorrow. So I testify in the name of the Creator, eternally bless mother's nature and brothers, take a stand and cherish that womb, man. Cherish that phenomenal womb, man. That womb.
Is it I go to work and I'm a mother and a wife? Is it I'm always here when you're in need from strife? Is it the way I walk that makes you turn your head and stare? Or is it the pools of my eyes that make you wanna stay hypnotized? Phenomenal.
Faith alive, exhale that secret, phenomenal personified.
I've got a secret that I wanna share with you. Please open up my heart and you can see.
Phenomenal. You truly are
phenomenal.
phenomenal womb.
You know, sometimes I get this pain deep in my veins. Sometimes I don't know what I'ma do because it's so intense. Sometimes I feel like it's gonna drive me insane. But see, one day I went outside and it started to rain. And when it started to rain, I realized that the pain started to subside. And all of a sudden, every day I wish that it would rain. Because see, this rain that I'm talking about was called truth. See, when I learned the truth about who I am and where I came from and what I was meant to be and the potential that was within me, all of a sudden the pain started to die out. But see, I needed more of that truth. Because see, when that rain comes down, it hits everything. It leaves nothing out. And see, for many years I went to school, and when I was in those schools, they kept leaving stuff out. And as they left more and more stuff out, I realized that when I got on the block and I was hanging with the homies, that I was kind of wilding out. And as I started to wild out, man, that pain got stronger, man. It started to drive me insane. I started getting high and I started drinking, man, just trying to ease that pain, man. And then one day one of the OGs told me, he said, "Look, young homie, reason why you feeling that pain, dog, is because you don't recognize, dog, that deep in your veins you got the ancestors calling your name. You hear their rage, man. See, those blood vessels in your veins ain't just blood, homie. That be the legacy of who you are, man. That be the people that made it for you to get to this point in history, man. That be your ancestors calling out your name, trying to remind you that you going insane chasing this gang thing. See, the rain, man. The rain brought me the truth and helped me to see that it wasn't about destroying my own, man. See, I look around the world as I travel around the world, and I look into South Africa, I look into South London, I look into Birmingham, Nottingham, man. And I travel all around this place, even to New York, man. And I see everybody trying to get on this gang thing, man. Don't they feel the pain? Why is it that they don't feel the pain? What have they done to this generation where they have numbed any aspects of intelligence in their brain? Is it too much MTV bass, man? Or is it too much, I just want to be a G-man with the big car and the diamond rings and the bling bling, man? I ain't got time for listening to what the olders got to say, or the G's got to say, or the elders got to say. Man, I'm trying to get paid. Man, I wish it would rain. Because see, it was only the rain that could bring about the change that was needed. It was only the truth when it rained down from the sky and hit everything and left nothing unturned. When that rain hit the sidewalk, all of a sudden it washed away the blood, and we can see where we were standing, man. We can see that where we were standing was nothing more than an auction block where they sold slaves to the highest bidder who wanted a place for their slaves in their new prison. And this is what it was all about, man. We could start to see, man. I could see that when my homeboy died, and he died at the hands of another that looks like me, that it wasn't necessarily that this is what he wanted. He had been driven insane. And man, I tell you, when I started to recognize what was happening in this game, all I could feel was the rage building up in my heart, man. See, all of a sudden, I can see that I was meant to be more than just a G, man. I was meant to be something stronger than a so-called gangster, man. Because see, you can't out-gangster the gangster, man. The one that stole your mama and your daddy and your great-grandpappy and put them on slave ships and did things to them that are so unmentionable to this day that for me just to mention it will make you crazy, man. And see, you so afraid of the real gangster, man, that you're afraid to even look him in his face and tell him to his face that I know I'm an African, and I know that you using my resources, and I know that you stolen my land, and I know that you took my name away from me. And you know something, homie? I'm here today to get it back, fool. Are you afraid of being true to what God made you? Man, I wish it would rain. Cause see, the rain washes away the pain, man. The rain is what makes my ancestors feel at ease, man. Because they know that once I know the truth, I will stand strong for what is right. They know that once I know the truth, that I have no choice but to fight every day and night to restore what was taken from me. They know that once I know the truth, that I got the ability to unleash a power of courage within my heart, unseen by any other human being but those that they call Africans, who build some of the greatest monuments in which everybody in this world today even still go to check out, homie. These Africans. You know, they built some of these great civilizations, like that place they call the United States. If it wasn't for Africans, it wouldn't be such a place to go to that have those great cities and those great skyscrapers, man. See, I'm talking about the courage of those soldiers who fought on the front line, and those soldiers who fought and flew those planes, the Tuskegee Airmen who were not afraid. I'm talking about those Zulu and Mandingo warriors who fought, the Asante and the Malayan warriors who fought, who was willing to bring the pain to those who was trying to drive us insane. This is what I mean when I talk about the courage in your heart, man. Man, I wish it would rain.
Because many people have labeled me a racist because I express my feelings in front of their faces. You ask me what it's like to be born and raised in this country, first thing I tell you, boy, for us, it ain't easy.